to law enforcement with a different perspective than Peter, but not entirely, because I was a public defender for 3 years in Union County, which meant that if I were a lot younger, he would have been my boss. But I started in the public defender, and the public defender just started in New Jersey back in the late 60s. And so it was kind of interesting for me to eventually become a prosecutor in Union County. And I had a little different perspective about what I thought should be done in the office. I'm law enforcement. I carry a badge that says law enforcement, but I'm not a cop. So I look at the role of a police officer in a different perspective than the lieutenant might and has. And I look at it in a different way than Peter does. I look at it as a policymaker in my office and a policymaker for police in our county. One of the things that I did when I started this job was to try to find out what is a police officer really doing. I'm going to talk about the state of police in New Jersey. Because I really didn't know what a prosecutor did. I mean, think about it. You can say, well, what does a prosecutor do? I'll ask you, you know, what that is, and you say, well, they prosecute cases. Well, that's about this much of it, very little. There's an awful lot more that is involved. The Attorney General, who was the general when I was appointed, indicated to me that I shouldn't be in my office. I should be spending my time on the streets with people and try to find a way to make lives a little bit better for not only the police, but also the public. I think back when he talked to me about the way it was back in the 1980s, and none of us were around at that time, but we certainly could read about it, when the cops were appointed because they were friends of a politician, because they were war keepers, because they got a job because they did a favor for somebody, and they didn't take as much money from a certain person if they would make sure that they were protected. There were a lot of bad reasons why. We think of the Keystone Cops, typically. And I heard a fellow this morning, I was listening to Imus, and he wrote a book about Teddy Roosevelt and what it was like, and all the houses of prostitution and all the corruption. And I'm thinking, what the hell is he talking about? Is he talking about now, or is he talking about, you know, back in the early 1900s? And he was talking about the 1900s. How police would sleep and they'd be wrapped on the heel with foot to wake them up. I mean, we have a lot of those impressions. And that did go on for quite a while. We don't accept that fact. There were a lot of gangs then, just as there are today. So you start to wonder, has life really changed? Are the police in the same position they were then as they are now? But I think it's different, because if you look at the ever-continuing change of police, you'll see that sometime around the 1940s, things were totally different. They started to become different. Police were more interested in obtaining facts. It was less of this casual contact and this friendship. They started to be appointed because they had maybe a high school education. Maybe they got the job on their merits. Maybe there was some positive things that could happen, including new innovations like fingerprints, unheard of in the early 1900s. These types of investigative techniques improved police, but it never really changed human nature. And it never will change. I don't care what anybody says. It's always going to be there. We're the same people now, and we'll be the same people, unfortunately, 150 years from now, as far as our human nature is concerned. But these police evolved. And I see, and I've been doing this now for almost 10 years, I see a difference now than I read about, and what I read about in the 1960s and 70s when I was a public defender and when I was doing a lot of defense work. And cops were different. They were not as well educated personally, which is to me a primary mandatory requirement. They should be educated, because the more they're educated, I think, the more their minds are opened up, the less prejudiced they are if they start reading and understand human nature and what it is and try to overcome. I think education helps a lot, and I think it did help a lot. I look, and I'm just going to jump right to now, the state. I look at these young cops, and I oversee a police academy, so I have another perspective. I can go to these. I'm going tomorrow morning, for instance, as an example, and review. And and I constantly am in touch with them. The men and women who are now involved, women are now involved, not just men, but women are involved, are, first of all, they're more educated. They are. They're more understanding, because a lot of them grew up, they didn't know, a lot of these young people now don't know what it was like to see the riots in New Jersey, in Newark. I was saying before, I was raised in Springfield Avenue and Bourbon Street, in the central ward of Newark, for the first 10 years of my life. And then I moved to the upper class of my Valesworth Park for a number of years, which was great. So I understand that, but these people, and even with my grandkids, I see it, they don't know the difference between black and white. When if you talk to them, they don't, there's, they're not learning to be prejudiced. When I was a kid, a lot of these older cops were raised, they were raised to be prejudiced. Blacks, Jews, Italians, Yukis like me, Polacks. I mean, that's the way it was. It has changed. I see the difference. But I also see another difference in these groups. I see that they're learning things, and I'll talk about it later on if you want, about what we're doing in Union County. And I think they're doing this in other counties. I see a difference in what they're learning in new investigative techniques. I see that there are safeguards in many ways for the defendants. We demand safeguards for the defendants, those accused. My position is not to be a prosecutor, surprise. My position is to be neutral, so that the victim's rights in a crime are protected as best as possible, so that the defendant's rights are protected, and so are the police. If people don't realize that, they assume a prosecutor is going to be pro-crime, that's it. I don't agree with some of the things that have been said. Because I see the prosecution statement by police officers who are corrupt and who violate the rights of other people. And I'm sure as hell positive that there are a lot of them getting away with it too. But I think with a new breed of police, hopefully prosecutors, even though I'm one of the older guys, that they have an open mind and their positions change when it comes to issues of internal affairs and things of that nature. So, I see that as my goal. I do say, presently, budgets are brutal. They're killing us. I talked to the president of the PBA not too long ago. He told me, and I don't know if this is accurate, 4,000 police officers were subject to losing their job. I think Newark may have 100 lost, or maybe Camden 100. I'm not sure the latest figure. But I know police are losing their job. I know in Union County, I'm losing officers. I have people on my homicide task force. I don't know if I'm going to continue to be able to do it because of the cutbacks. It definitely affects morale. It definitely makes a difference. That cop is going out on the street, sometimes he's pissed, pardon me, language, I don't use that anymore, that would stay. But they're upset, and they have a right to be upset because they don't know if they have a job. In the same way, young people who live in a poverty situation are upset and angry because when they come home, they don't know if they're going to have a home. They don't know if they're going to have a place to stay at night. They don't know if they're going to have food. That's another issue. But these police officers are upset. I don't buy the thing about the crime example. In Union County, it's up. Elizabeth, it's up. Statewide, it may be down 1 point from 09 to 10. And maybe we're lucky it's down another 1%. That's not a drop in crime for me. Not when you see how high the crime rate is. So I think that there are issues. I think the recession has created some of those problems. For politicians, some of them are horrible. They don't recognize that there are gangs. They don't recognize that I shouldn't be the only responsible person to eliminate gang. They have to stop before they start. These young kids, they need a lot more than they need a prosecutor. A lot of them need family love, tough love, they need gentle love. I was in Moselle last night, we had 500 people. Because last Thursday night I was called out, two young people in their 20s were shot, killed, one in the back, one in the head, and two others were wounded by another, one gunman who was a prick. And they were all crip gang. They came out, 500 people came out, and they were looking at us. Not only were they angry, they were fearful, and they were looking to the police. So we can complain all we want, and we can bitch and moan all we want, and we'll use that word again. But the reality is that if we have a problem, we turn to the police, and that's good. But it also means that we have to protect those who come to the police to make sure that they're treated appropriately. Now, the lieutenant doesn't know that when I heard he was going to be on this panel, I bought his book, and I read it. And I agree with him. Maybe about a third of it, but half. I do agree with him. Positions on the rights and whatever. You and I may disagree, but the bottom line is we'll never disagree on one thing, that we live under the best constitution of anyone that ever existed at any time in the world, and that we have to make certain that people's rights are protected all the same.
Thank you. Alec?
Back in the late 60s. And so it was kind of interesting for me to eventually become a prosecutor in Union County. And I had a little different perspective about what I thought should be done in the office. I'm law enforcement. I carry a badge that says law enforcement, but I'm not a cop. So I look at the role of a police officer. I'll sit here for a while. I come to law enforcement with a different perspective than Peter, but not entirely, because I was a public defender for 3 years in Union County, which meant that if I were a lot younger, he would have been my boss. I started in the public defender, and the public defender just started in New Jersey. Wasn't really doing. I'm going to talk about the state of police in New Jersey, because I really didn't know what a prosecutor did. I mean, think about it. You can say, well, what does a prosecutor do? I'll ask you, you know, what that is, and you say, well, they prosecute cases. Well, that's about this much of it, very little. There's an awful lot more that is involved. The attorney general, who was the officer in a different perspective than the lieutenant might and has, and I look at it in a different way than Peter does. I look at it as a policymaker in my office and a policymaker for police in our county. One of the things that I did when I started this job was to try to find out what is a police officer general when I was appointed. Indicated to me that I shouldn't be in my office. I should be spending my time on the streets with people and try to find a way to make lives a little bit better for not only the police, but also the public. I think back when he talked to me about the way